made for this. And I'm gonna play like this is the only chance. And it is the only chance. He was spying on us.
That's true.
This is your shot. I'm like, there's no freaking way. Like, we just look and he's right there, just back home. My mom says I'm a little fireball. And if this was the real world, I would not hold back. But if he's going around spying on us like that, so early on in the game, he can't be trusted.
You know what I always got made fun of growing up? My big toe is way longer than my little toes.
So it looks worse those on, footprints the on the beach.
My big toe is just abnormally longer than my other toes. Because it's usually like this, right? But then this toe is like this.
Is that like really long?
Like it's long.
But you know what, guys? I have
great
impeccable
grip.
Balance.
Yes.
Everybody's laughing now, but they won't laugh later when I win based off a balance challenge.
Oh my God.
Big toe energy. Woo, let's go.
I was like super paranoid the first 2 days.
That's all I was.
Yeah.
Dee is my closest ally.
Dee, I think we can go far.
I know we can.
I know, I really do.
So I was thinking last night about Austin and Drew. They have something. Do you not feel the vibe?
You think?
Yeah. I've noticed that him and Austin have been having a lot of one-on-one time together. And then every time we're walking a treadmill walking back, they whisper to each other.
So right now, I have a great alliance with Mama Julie. And then Mama Julie, Austin, Drew, and I, we got like a four thing going on.
Yeah, you got a shot.
But there's certain things that I've noticed about Drew and Austin, which makes me think that something's going on there.
Last night, we were crabbing, hunting.
Yeah.
We found a beware advantage.
Yeah.
The first thing that came out was a clue, which was, well, there's multiple tasks that have to be solved. The first one was to decode that message.
You know, I don't think they would have told us had we not caught Drew. But regardless, the moment that we found out that he did find a beware advantage and he was looking for an idol, Mama Julie and I, we decided that, like, hey, all right, we're gonna work together. We're gonna help you find the sign.
Are you kidding me?
Mama Julie and I, we didn't really need to give the hammer away. We could have gone to the water world by ourselves, smashed it and kept the idol for ourselves. But to be honest, at this point, good alliances, that's what's gonna get me further in the game. Now we know that there is trust. You know, like before we felt it, now we can prove that there is trust.
Love you.
I love you so much.
Okay. I like Sean. And I do think that him and I, the more that we get together, I do think we're gonna click. But right now, Sean could potentially have an advantage or an idol.
Open, oh, won't. It's fine. We gotta try it the same way.
So we go to open his bag, but we notice that the strings in his bag are tight and in a weird position. They're all like this. And we're like, is he doing this on purpose? That means he has to have something, so we have to go through his bag.
This one comes up
under
this way and then goes through.
Over and under this one. So what we did is we got one of our red bags and we tried to decipher how he tied it. And then we tied our red bag exactly how he tied his yellow bag to tie it back up again. Even if Sean does know we went through his bag, you're at the bottom, buddy. Like, you should expect that we're gonna go through your bag. So right now, that's like at the bottom of my worries.
So what are we thinking?
It has to be a group decision.
Yeah, it has to be us for sure.
If we vote out Sean, we actually have a chance at a challenge tomorrow.
At this point, it doesn't matter to me as much as
it doesn't matter
either. If Sifu plays an idol with the three of us, one of us goes home. So tonight's our best bet at getting him out.
Okay, Sifu's first, then Sean, three, we merge.
We've been saying Reba strong, but now that the swap is here, we gotta pivot and we gotta adapt and we gotta take people out that we don't trust, and that's the game.
But you gotta trust that we're not putting it in.
Yeah.
So respectfully, I would kindly ask that when you vote tonight, that you write my name down on the parchment.
So the only question left is, what is the group gonna do? Were they already voting you out? Maybe they weren't and you've changed their mind. Maybe they weren't and you didn't change their mind. That's what we're gonna find out.
I love you as a person, but I hate you as a player.
Dee. That's one vote Sifu, one vote Sean, one vote Dee. Fourth person voted out of Survivor 45, Sean.
I am coming up with a surprise.
I'm not ready to talk about it.
Tribal Council could not have gotten any worse. It should have been Sifu going home, but he's still here. And now
It's bad because he's pissed that one of us voted him, which, yes, it was me. But we had the perfect plan to get the person out of our freaking tribe who has been causing chaos this entire time. This is the time where you need to put your heart aside and play the game.
What did you guys write?
I wrote Sean with the smiley face.
I wrote Sean.
I wrote Sean too.
See, now I respect him even less.
I do too,
because we had a plan. And then to tell Sifu that he didn't vote for him, like, what does that do to us? You blow up the game without you being in the game. Like,
Yep. That's
kind of messed up. I can't respect that. I can't fathom quitting. I always go back to my why, like my family. I think about them every single day. Like, they are the reason why I want to succeed. I was born in Cuba and I'm an immigrant, so my parents brought my brother and I to the United States. And every time I think that I'm starving out here, I just try to cut that thought out and I say, well, my parents literally starved in Cuba their entire lives until they came to the United States. And I'm out here, like, at least drinking fresh water, and they had to carry buckets on their head up flights of stairs every day. They came from Cuba without having anything. So quitting for me is not an option because I don't come from a family that quits.
Yep. It was the most perfect plan in the world.
I'm not worried because I have an advantage.
And I don't. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's huge.
Right now, it's Operation Throw Jay Under the Bus. It makes the most sense. Sifu and her don't have a good relationship.
I'm just thinking different options.
We're saying just throw Jay.
This is perfect. I still have my four strong alliance. So Mama Juliana are still extremely close. Then Drew and Austin, like, they're the people that I trust the most in this game. I'll put anybody's name out there except theirs.
Okay, at what point are we getting Jay out?
Dude, she needs to go.
For me, it's Jay, for sure. I'll tell you the name that I want voted out. Jay.
Mike, I'm shocked by that, but
I know, because it's Reba. Jay wasn't really part of our Reba alliance with the four of us, so sorry, Jay, but whatever, it's gonna be over and we're gonna forgive each other.
I wouldn't mind writing her name, though.
I'm a little bit surprised.
Dangerous thing is the fact that there's a block of three Reba women who've been together for 13 days. And I think for Dee and for Julie, there's an opportunity if you guys let go of Jay,
right? You wanna mention some other threats while you're at it? Yeah. So how would we trust you if you're saying you're by yourself and you're trying to find a home? Who's the home? Nobody knows. And of course I feel strongly about it because I heard my name and I'm Cuban, so I gotta push and fight. But do I wanna work with you now that you threw my name out in tribal council?
Sixth person voted out of Survivor 45. Jay, that's six, that's enough.
Okay. Right now, gives a nod to her. Dee wins award for her group. Yeah, what a challenge.
That's it, Dee.
Come on. Individual immunity, safe tonight at Tribal Council. I saw tears the second you won. What's the emotion? Share.
Jeff, I was just thinking about my family up there, my parents, my brother, and like the pool signified like the American dream for me, and I knew I wasn't gonna let go. And then I just kept thinking, like, I wanna take care of them, I wanna take care of them. You got this. And I just wanna make them proud, I wanna take care of them, and that's what matters.
I have a feeling they're proud. Congratulations, you are safe tonight.
My freaking toes came into play today. I said, this is gonna help me out. They're kind of cute, but they're just like too long right here. But look at where it saved me. Survivor, who knows, this may have been the $1 million gameplay. I'm here winning the first immunity challenge because of my toes. Oh boy. I am thinking Caleb.
I want to do whatever you decide.
Right.
And I'll push whatever story you want.
Austin doesn't want to vote Caleb. I feel like he wants to keep the big threats, but I'm the one who's in the position of power. So we're voting Caleb, no matter what. So Caleb is goner. Boy, bye.
Could have worked together, but you burned the bridge last time.
Eighth person voted out of Survivor 45 and the first member of our jury, Caleb.
Once I found my first one, I'm like, okay, I know what I'm looking for. It's game on, baby. It's game on. Bruce was walking back. I'm like, dude, that's why you're not finding anything. You gotta run back. Like, what are you doing? Just chilling, you know? Like, this is not vacation.
Chocolate milkshake.
Oh. I'm sorry, I gotta put in my money, 900. Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
wants a $900 milkshake. Damn, Dee. Nice.
Sold it now. Everything you had. You gotta try it.
That's a joke, man.
Oh, girl, that looks amazing.
I feel like I'm on vacation.
I want Dee.
Okay. Is Dee the biggest threat on Reba?
100%.
Kendra is coming after you hard now.
I figured. It's okay.
Who'd you want to take out?
Kendra.
Okay, I think same thing.
The fact that Kendra did not win made my entire year.
Kendra's such a wild card.
She gotta go, because she's stirring up the pot, and she's putting my name out there. So yeah, okay, Kendra, get some rotisserie chicken, but you're gonna be eating more of that soon when you're out of this game. We did not get some rotisserie chicken, but we got a ton of rice that Jake didn't eat because we ate more than he thinks we ate.
She got it. Kendra for sure wants me out.
Well, Kendra was like, well, I want Dee. I said, I'm gonna be honest with you. I will write Dee.
Yeah.
I said, can I write Jake?
Have them think it's Jake then.
And
how we go and vote Kendra out.
I already know everybody wants Jake out, which seems like such an easy vote.
But I don't want that. She's trying to get me out.
I need to do what's best for my game. And right now, I want Kendra out. But in this game, whoever throws out my name, I'm gonna come for them. I'm gonna come for them hard. Things cross your mind, and then you don't know if it's paranoia, but you don't know if it's the truth. And as players, I feel like we're evolving. Like, you know, as a Pokemon, you evolve into like Charizard. I feel like that's what the new era is. It's like an evolution.
10th person voted out and the third member of our jury, Kendra.
Obviously, we're gonna split vote between Jake and Bruce. They're huge threats for my Alliance members, and we've been pretty much dominating together. If we hear names, we go after them.
Member of our jury, Bruce, need to bring me your torch?
Coming into this game, I felt like a very calming presence with Austin. And now that it's getting closer to the end, our relationship is progressing. It makes me happy because I feel like he's such a genuine guy.
You know, when I first saw you, I thought you didn't like me.
Really?
A little bit. You
Why?
Never smiled at me.
I think initially Austin wasn't someone that I'd be interested in. But, you know, you spend so much time with people here. You know, when they say 26 days on Survivor, it really is like 6 months out here. Came into this game saying no showmances. Literally, one of my biggest things was no showmances. But that doesn't mean I can't have a little fun. After Tribal Council, we got together, the four of us, and we made a pact that it's going to be the four of us strong. Drew, Austin, Julie, and I, we still need each other because there's still 6 days left in the game, and we don't know what Jeff is going to throw at us. So right now, I'm looking at Emily next.
There's a strong movement against Julie.
Yeah,
I know.
My mind is going crazy right now because Julie's my other number one. If I choose to vote Julie out, it's just me and Austin. There's still 7 people left in the game. Like, there's still more game to be played, more twists to come. And if I don't have my 2 number ones, then I'm in the chopping block.
But you need to put on your biggest acting face, play your idol tonight. And we're gonna vote Emily out. But you have to put on your biggest acting face.
Okay, so you think I'm another option?
You are the option. I'm gonna write you 2.
Yep.
Because then we're gonna hate each other after this.
Okay.
And you're gonna play your idol and you're writing Emily.
Got you.
Okay?
Got you.
Play the damn idol.
Julie does not count. One vote left. Person voted out and the 5th member of our jury. Emily.
I basically had to act when Julie played her idol. I had to be so surprised and look at everyone like, even though I knew what was gonna happen because I told her what to do. I had to automatically become awkward in front of everyone. I gotta be the best actress that I've been in my entire life. It's a game, we're almost done. We can act for a few more days.
How did she tell her?
What did my mother even tell her anything?
I know.
She didn't even look at me. We have to keep moving because I'll start laughing.
It's even harder to act back at camp. When you orchestrate such a big blindside, you cannot tell anybody. Because the moment that comes out of my mouth, even if it's to Austin, who's my other number one, I am risking $1 million. Out here, I'm gonna swear on everybody. I'm gonna swear on my dogs, I'm gonna swear on my mom, on my dad, and they're gonna still be alive when I leave here, and they're gonna be happy when I win, and that I swore for them.
Drew is the one that has said your name before. I swear.
It's so hard right now.
This is the best day of my life.
Oh my God, I think we're on my camp.
Austin's relationship and I is progressing. Anytime a man tells you something, you should never believe them until he puts actions behind his words. And Austin did that when he chose me first for the reward. Hey, I want to spend this afternoon having this experience with you. That's the way I took it. And I was happy about it. So, yeah. What's the question?
What's the deal with you and Austin?
Well,
you're acting like you're a little bit smitten.
I am a little bit smitten. I don't know how to answer the question. He's a cool guy. I like him.
And he does it. Austin drops. Dee wins her second individual immunity.
Dee, you didn't move.
Safe tonight at Tribal Council. Guaranteed a spot in the
final five, which is absolutely insane. But even more than wearing this necklace, as pretty as it is, you know, I want to go out partying with it. It makes me feel good because I'm a woman. And, like, I'm going against these men, and it's like, I'm going to give you a run for your money, whether you like it or not.
So I don't want to tell Indy.
One, two, three, Drew. I think the fact that I voted for Julie last Tribal Council, thank freaking God that I did that, because it showed that I was still with them in this game. Drew trusts me right now, and he won't see it coming. It is hard because, like, my morals are coming in the way, you know? But then I also told myself coming in here, like, Dee, you cannot let your emotions get in the way.
Who are you voting for tonight? Are you?
I don't know. Should I tell Austin or should I not tell Austin? You're forced to make tough decisions. And I told myself coming in here, I made a promise to myself, I knew what was gonna be my weakness. I knew it. But I knew that my weakness was my emotions getting involved and trying to balance my morals in the real world with my morals on Survivor. It's hard.
15th person voted out and the sixth member of our jury. Drew, need to bring me your torch?
Trust you still, I promise.
Even after I played a part in the Drew blindside, Austin took it so freaking well that it made me, like, it made me feel for him more. Like, it made me want to, like, hug him even harder, you know?
He found it.
He found it?
And he made me promise not to tell anyone. He's going to play it tonight on himself.
So then we got to vote Katora then.
Yeah.
Jake having an idol at this point in the game ruins my plans.
He wants Julie out, right?
He wants Julie out.
So now, because Austin has immunity, Jake has an idol, that leaves me, Julie, and Katora 1 in 3 chances of going home.
Dee, one vote Jake, one vote Dee.
Dee has won the final immunity challenge of Survivor 45, her third individual win.
Ideally, Austin's next to me because we have a plan to go to the end together.
Do you want to talk right now?
Okay.
And the reason why I would throw Katora and Jake in the fire is because I know that Jake can beat Katora. I think Katora has played a better game than Jake. She's more of a social threat.
I'm bringing Austin to the final three.
The tribe has spoken.
Love you.
Love you. I literally am living the dream. I'm living the Survivor dream. Final three on day 26. All I can think is, Mama, I made it. Mommy, Papi, this is for you. And whether I win or not, they're going to be proud of me. I am going to win, though, but...
You mentioned that I was scared because I was being seen as a threat, which I was. I've heard my name come up. But I wasn't really scared, honestly, because I had a core alliance, and I knew that they weren't going to vote me out, and that's how strong my social game was. Can I say something? Austin sat me down on the beach and was like, Dee, it's time. Like, I think we're all thinking of taking Julie out. How do you feel about that? And I just agreed to it. You don't know this, but I did tell Julie. I did tell Julie. I'm so sorry. So sorry. But I knew that she had an idol. And the moment that everyone spread out, I told Julie, everyone's coming for you, but you're not going home tonight. You're going to play the idol that we found on yourself, and we're going to blindside Emily. Julie came here and wrote Emily's name down. She did not write Austin's name down. So I also did risk for you going home. But I knew deep down, my social game was so good. People trusted me. When I gave my word, it was my word. And I still didn't tell him for the rest of the days that we were here together. We're final three and he didn't know.
Dee. Dee. Two votes Dee. One vote Austin. Dee. That's three votes Dee. Dee. That's four votes Dee. Wow. The winner of Survivor 45. Dee.
There it is. We have a winner. Come on over, jury. Dee is the winner of Survivor 45.